A type of kinetic energy recovery system, regenerative braking transfers the kinetic energy of a moving object into potential or stored energy. In this episode of Radwell's How It Works series, we are going to explore how regenerative braking works. First, let's review the main components of regenerative braking. First is the power supply, which supplies power to the system. Second is the drive, which controls the motor. Third is the motor, which moves the machinery. Now that we've reviewed the main components of regenerative braking, let's talk about how it works. First, power is supplied to the motor to operate. While the load is moving, the motor is using power. However, if the motor is overhauled, meaning that the load is moving faster than the motor speed or the motor is braking, then the motor acts as a generator and begins supplying power back to the drive. Depending on the drive setup, this regenerated power can be supplied to a common DC bus to be used elsewhere in the system or back to the power supply. Regenerative braking is best used for continuous duty applications and machinery that constantly starts and stops, such as elevators, cranes, hoists, incline conveyors, robots, and electric vehicles. If you like this information on regenerative braking, like this video and subscribe to our channel for more information on industrial products and processes. Also, be sure to check out our What Is video to learn more about regenerative braking. For information about Radwell, visit us on the web at radwell.com or connect with us on social media. Thanks for watching!